Welcome to Ticket News TV, your source for up-to-date developments in the ticketing industry. In this edition, we bring you the latest news affecting the concert, sports, and theater industries worldwide. Social media is continuing to play a key role in the secondary ticket market. Daily Deal website, Groupon, and Live Nation are partnering to launch a new ticket website that will offer local deals on tickets for concerts and other events. The arrangement will allow Live Nation's Ticketmaster division and its thousands of clients to unload hard-to-sell ticket inventory at a discount to fill otherwise empty seats. The new website will be called grouponlive.com. On April 25th, Connecticut legislatures withdrew a proposed ticket resale bill that would have regulated paperless ticketing in the state for the first time. The General Assembly's General Law Committee, which overwhelmingly approved the bill in March, decided to send it to the state's Department of Consumer Protection for review instead of to the Assembly floor. The bill will not move forward during the current legislative session, but will be revisited again in 2012. In sports, the NBA Finals ended Sunday, June 12th, with Dirk Nowitzki and the Dallas Mavericks winning their first NBA championship title in franchise history. The Mavericks won 105-95 against LeBron James, Dwayne Wade, and the Miami Heat. Dallas's win followed a postseason tournament that saw the team also easily take down the LA Lakers and Oklahoma City Thunder. In concert news, rap star Lil Wayne continues to dominate the North American tour circuit, where he has experienced huge success over the past few years. He plans to continue this streak with another leg of the I'm Still Music tour, where he will perform with Carrie Hilson, Lloyd, Far East Movement, and Rick Ross. The tour includes stops in Virginia Beach, the San Francisco Bay Area, and Toronto, Canada. Summer festival Lollapalooza is celebrating its 20th anniversary. Eminem, The Foo Fighters, Coldplay, and Muse will headline at Chicago's Grant Park from August 5th to 7th. Legendary piano man Elton John will begin a residency this September in Las Vegas at the Coliseum in Caesar's Palace. The show, entitled The Million Dollar Piano, is booked for a three-year block. And Britney Spears has confirmed Nicki Minaj as a special guest during the Femme Fatale Tour. The concert series kicked off on June 17th at the Power Balance Pavilion in Sacramento, California. On the theater circuit, Broadway ticket sales slowed a bit for the week ending June 5th. Ticket sales grossed about $20 million, down from nearly $23 million reported the previous week. Several new shows opened on Broadway earlier this year to critical acclaim, including Sister Act, Jerusalem, Born Yesterday, and House of Blue Leaves. Wicked continues to dominate ticket sales for all Broadway shows. In other ticket industry news, Fred Rosen, the former CEO of Ticketmaster and current co-CEO of Outbox Enterprises, will give the keynote address at the Ticket Summit Conference and Trade Show. The upcoming conference will be held in Las Vegas from July 13th through 15th, 2011, at the Venetian Resort Hotel Casino. The July appearance marks Rosen's second time speaking at the Ticketing and Live Entertainment Trade Show. He previously gave a keynote address at Ticket Summit in 2007. Thank you for joining us for this edition of Ticket News TV. For daily updates on industry developments, visit ticketnews.com. In Vernon, Connecticut, I'm Kim Crandall.